Today we are rewinding the clock and becoming a kid again. These are some of the coolest RC construction trucks. At almost $750 combined, these things aren't super cheap, but they are legit. We've got metal buckets up front. They can actually push and move and carry materials and dirt and rocks around. It's good, clean fun. It's a great hobby, young and old. I've been having a ton of fun playing with them with my little boy. If you guys are in the RC sport or you're considering getting into it, these might be worth taking a look, maybe for this upcoming holiday season. I'm Ben Schmanke from AuthenTech. I got all three of these sent to me from Banggood. Huge thanks to those guys. And if you want to check out more info, I'll give you my affiliate links plus any coupon codes down in the description. So I got an excavator, a wheel loader, and a dump truck. Now, all three of them work together awesome, but each one has its own fun capabilities, so you don't have to get all three. The excavator and the dump truck, well, they say it's 1/14 scale, and the wheel loader, it's 1/18 scale. So as you can see, these things are pretty massive in size. They aren't your cheapy dollar store toys. There's great attention to a lot of the details on these trucks. I love getting the camera or just my perspective super low, and as they move and work, it feels like the real deal. With all three together, or just one or two and a couple bags of cheap sand, it's endless hours of fun. Now, it's great times with my kids and learning and playing together, but then it's also kind of fun just playing them by myself. It's almost zen, calming, digging, pushing, moving. So it takes a bit of practice learning the controls, mainly the excavator and the wheel loader. There's a bit of a learning curve, and especially might be harder for younger kids, but it's great practice. And then once you get the hang of the controls, you kind of feel like a pro just swiveling the cab around, moving the boom with the teeth and the bucket, stretching out the stick and swinging the arm, curling, scraping, pulling up the dirt. It's like just super fun as you learn to move the controls collectively together for those more realistic movements. One thing I really like with all three of these is there's finesse in the controls. It's not just like all the way on or off. So if I just move the stick a little bit, it's nice and slow and controlled. And if you go fast all the way, you can really see it. And that's same with the boom and the bucket. Yeah, we can move it nice and slow and controlled or super fast and all the different axes at the same time. And it's really nice. I love that finesse. There's lights and sounds on these things as you move. Kind of adds to that effect of realism. I personally like to turn off the sounds. They get a little annoying, but the lights are super cool. I know on this guy, when you're backing up and turning, you get the blinkers on the tail lights. It's just those fun little touches make it feel a bit more realistic. Now we have rubber tires on the wheel loader and the dump truck, which kind of adds some of that gription. And then over here on the excavator tracks, it's semi-grippy rubber with a little bit of plastic, but not too much slipping around. Plus, the excavator is not supposed to be racing around the track. Both of these guys are a little bit faster. This guy's a little bit slower of a mover, but again, that's realistic too, I guess. There's so many fun digging and moving scenarios that we got into. Let me show you a couple. It's fun using all three to move sand, dirt, gravel, or even mulch. Sometimes when there was a dirty job site and the sand was spread around, I was using that wheel loader to push and move and clean up the mess. That was kind of cool. I even once used the wheel loader to clean up my kids' toys on the back patio. Once the dump truck got stuck and the wheels were just kind of spinning out, emptying its bed, so I used the wheel loader to lift up the front end and help push it out and free. Here, the wheel loader couldn't drive over the larger step of the brick, so I made a little ramp for itself to drive itself up and out. Same with the excavator, it's strong enough that, and then look at it, it can lift itself up and over different obstacles. That's pretty cool. Battery life on all three of these are pretty good. They come with these little rechargeable LiPos with the USB charger. That's kind of nice and convenient, though it's a slow trickle charge. I found for battery life, well, I didn't time it exactly, but for a little example, I was playing with all three of these for a little while. I'd say an hour or two, kind of on and off filming. Took a rest, turned them off. The next day I came back, played with them some more, turned them off. And then even on the third day, there was still battery life left to move around. It was maybe getting low around then. So I think it'll give you a few hours for sure of good play time. Now there's a few shortcomings or wish list items. Now the wheel loader, it's realistic. The pivot point is here in the middle. It doesn't actually twist or turn the wheels. But on the downside of that, your turning radius isn't super tight. Obviously no tracks and things like that. So I was finding I had to kind of make some wider turns on the movements, not big deal. A negative on the dump truck, well, the bed doesn't seem to raise high enough. I think they rated about 45 degrees. Maybe the surface isn't slick enough or something. Even with sand, sometimes it would get stuck in the back end, which is a little bit of annoying. I found I had to kind of move the truck forward and backward and rock the load out the back. And sometimes that works, sometimes things got stuck. Another little issue I found with this wheel loader when I was trying to raise the bucket up high enough to empty in the dump truck, it seemed like the boom couldn't raise just high enough to fully empty the bucket. Now my janky, not so realistic solution was to either rock the little sucker back and forth and kind of shove it in there, or once I made myself this little bed to drive up and raise up the front tires, this helped. Either way, I just wish that bucket could tip a little bit more and the boom maybe raise a bit higher. As for strength of these guys, I mean, they're pretty strong. You can pick up a full load of gravel and rocks and sand and move all that stuff around, which is cool. However, it's not for digging actual holes. You're not gonna be making the tree size holes or digging fence post holes with these things. It's not really meant for that. It's still definitely toy hobby grade. They're not hydraulic systems that cost thousands of dollars, though I'd love to get my hands on one of those. Those look pretty cool. It's just a dang fun toy to play around. It's great for kids learning remote control and even how heavy machinery works. Now, which one is my favorite between these three? Well, I think it'd be a tie between these two. However, taking price into consideration, the excavator, I think, is on sale right now, $167. That's not bad for what you're getting, and there's still a ton of fun use cases that you can play with it. I love the wheel loader. There's actually probably more versatility carrying bigger loads and moving it around, and you can still dig and push and move. However, looking at the price tag, I think it's about $330 right now, which is quite a bit more expensive. And then as for the dump truck, it's kind of a perfect marriage or add-on to one of these things. It's just great to carrying a full load of material, dumping it, and then moving it around. And then for price tag, the dump truck is the cheapest at about $116 right now, so it's not bad. Oh, and I also reviewed this other dump truck years ago. It's about half the price at like $60. It wasn't bad either, but funny enough, I think it had the same issues, if I'm remembering, that the bed couldn't raise high enough to fully slide out the load. So it's just a little bit of a shortcoming, but there's that one if you want to check it out. I'll give you all the links down below. So either way, if you're into RC or construction, or you're just looking for a new hobby, these things are a ton of fun. I'm having a blast and will continue to play with them over the years with my little boy and I. And yeah, thanks so much for watching, guys. Thanks to Banggood for sending them over, and I'll see you guys in the next one.